There's a lot of programs out there for people who have nothing, but there aren't very many programs for people who have very little. And so we try to help those people.
I was a mess. Before I came here, I couldn't walk. I was an immobilizer. My leg didn't know what was wrong. I had problems with my neck, woke up and couldn't move. I was a total mess.
They saved my life, and I'm so grateful to them.
They were able to address my needs basically through medication and then just treat me like a human being.
I can't look at me and say, hi, Jose, how are you?
Yeah, this is the people who greet me, hi, Jose, how are you? That's what makes you feel like a family here at Mission of Mercy.
I heard about Mission of Mercy through a friend. They said if you need any kind of life-threatening medication or you're in pain and you don't know what to do, go there. They'll help you. Yeah, I am employed. They do give insurance, but it costs too much. I came in with a brace on my leg. They felt so bad for me. I had a mobilizer on and I had a neck brace on. And I think I was so worried. I was in so much pain. I'll never forget it. You know what them big mobilizers look like. So I look like an invalid walking in here in tears. So I was in a lot of pain, you know, and I couldn't work because of the pain either.
I was literally knocking at death's door. I was in intensive care 3 different times. The first time was blood clots that I had, and I had medical insurance then because I was still working for the sisters. The 2 last times when I was in the hospital, I came for follow-up here because not having medical insurance, basically.
I had lost a job, and I had no insurance, and I'm a diabetic, and had a thyroid condition, but I couldn't go to a doctor because I had no money and no insurance. And my sister works for United Healthcare, and she had heard about Mission of Mercy, and she called and got me an appointment. It was very frightening not to have insurance because I'd always had it, you know, my whole life. And not being able to go to a doctor to get medication, and so my medical problems just ran rampant. And I lost down to 97 pounds. And I mean, I was very sick and scared because there wasn't anything I could do until I turned 65. And at the time I was only in my 50s. And even thinking about going to the emergency room if I felt like there was an emergency, I didn't have insurance, so I didn't feel like I could do that. You know, it was scary.
Some patients that have come here, I've almost thought it was the best thing that ever happened to them that they lost their health insurance, because we've caught things that were missed in the rush and flow of a regular routine doctor's visit.
For some people, this is their primary care. They have charts. They've been with the mission for many, many years. We see patients with anything from a cold to diabetes.
¿Cuánto tiempo ha tenido diabetes?
Mire, yo la diabetes de...
My blood sugar content was over 500. And it has been under control since 2008. And since then, Mission of Mercy has kept it under control, and now it's 160.
Bueno, yo el trato que me da la Misión de Mercy es excelente.
I feel that they treat me really well. I also had problems with my teeth. My gums used to bleed, and they helped me with that as well.
Porque todos los que ven,
all those people over there that you can see, they come here because they get an excellent treatment.
There's just all kinds of needs out there, and they come in with them, and we do our best to meet them. We can't always, but we do our best. We'll stand on our head if we have to try.
They put me on the right medicines. I don't have a thyroid at all, so they made sure I get my thyroid medicine, because I can get sick from that too. I really rely on them a lot. Never want another doctor. I wouldn't survive without them. Wouldn't be able to work, wouldn't have a normal life, you know, without Mission of Mercy. Love them. love them to death. Never missed an appointment in 7 years. Even if I'd come here and they say, well, we don't got your medicine for you. That's okay as long as you're here, you know?
The nurses were incredible because I had no idea about the organization except that what they did. And they wanted to buy me cheeseburgers to put weight on. But I mean, they helped me fill out all the forms to get certain medications. And they were just absolutely incredible. So caring, and they know you by name. Of course, I've been coming here for like 6 years, so.
Yeah, I feel secure and comfortable, and knowing that there's somebody there that cares.
My life would be a disaster because I think I would be dead. Diabetes kills.
I always give my doctor a hug too before I leave, just to let them know I'll be back.
I not only say thank you, but I also say, keep up the good work, because you're a godsend to the community, and you're really doing your part to help a lot of people out who would normally maybe fall by the wayside and not have any help at all.
I wouldn't be alive. I wouldn't be alive if I hadn't been able to come here.
The skills that I have are what I can do. That's what I can do. I can't do everything. I can't even do much, but it's what I can do, and I think I get a lot more out of it than I put into it.
I think that for a lot of us, what we do is a calling.